today we are talking about type 2 diabetes and genetics. We know that type 2, we Indians have 3 times more risk of having type 2 diabetes. But when we compare with the white Caucasian population, but we don't know why we have more type 2 diabetes compared to Caucasian population. So large number of group led by Prof. Chambers and Kuna, west of London, they did study and trying to identify the genes factor. But unfortunately, nothing much came out understanding that these genes were responsible for type 2 diabetes. And then the epigenetics phenomena started evolving for the last 15-20 years time, and then we know about epigenetics phenomena as phenomena which can, the environmental effect on the genes can interplay and cause the risk of certain diseases. And our study published in Nature Genetics have shown that type 2 diabetes is, some to an extent, is been related to epigenetics phenomena. When we studied the epigenetics phenomena, part of the long study with Prof. Chambers and Kuna, we could only explain that it's a 1/3 risk of having diabetes could be explained by epigenetics phenomena. So the world is trying to be curious about it, why Indians have 3 times more risk of diabetes, not simply have 3 times more risk of diabetes, 3 times more risk of having heart disease. If you have heart disease, they do much worse than the Caucasian population. So we don't know all this phenomena. And we have, if you look at United Kingdom, there is 70% decline in cardiovascular disease, heart disease going down. But we have rise in 30% rise per annum of cardiovascular disease, people dying suddenly. And if you look from the COVID phenomena, why the Italians and the Spanish are dying at older age? Because the population live longer. So if they get COVID, it's an older population who would die of diabetes. It's not the younger population will get type 2 diabetes. So when what we are talking about, that when you come to India, you see a much younger population who have much more risk of diabetes, and the younger population getting COVID, and the younger population relatively dying compared to the Italians and Spanish. Because we don't keep, as a population, our demography is not that old. We think it's a much younger population because we don't live longer. Why don't we live longer? Because type 2 diabetes is coming younger and causing much more higher death rates. But that's why we're not, as a population, living longer. So we need to understand that. And what COVID has done is precipitated the risk of type 2 diabetes, the cardiovascular disease in patients with diabetes, hypertension, cardiovascular risk factors, obesity. So what COVID is, if you look at it, what's happening in COVID is precipitating heart disease, precipitating the heart attack, stroke. That's what people are dying. People are not dying of COVID infection or septicemia, but majority of people dying are high risk people. So we need to ultimately go back to cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, that's why we're not living longer. And these patients who died yesterday in our country, large number, or the whole world population, it is old age, diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol, smoking, obesity, lack of exercise. So these are the risk of people who tend to die. So we need to understand, going back to genetics or omics phenomena, to understand. Now, when it comes to genetics and to type 2 diabetes, so it's a multifactorial, it's a different genes factor which is responsible for it. Environmental plays and affects the gene behavior, and we understand the type 2 diabetes. But do we know everything about it? We don't know everything about it. Now, diabetes is something called multifactorial. There are multiple genes responsible for type 2 diabetes. But there are single gene defect diabetes. It's called MODY type 2 diabetes. And there are single genes, there are certain MODY 1 to 13 to 14 which has been responsible for creating a single gene diabetes. So when it comes to MODY, there are single gene defects. So what is this MODY diabetes? We don't know a little about it, but we also understand that MODY diabetes runs in the family. There are younger population, less than 30 years old, usually very thin, but doesn't matter that you're obese, will be protected of MODY genes. If you passed on genes from your family, you have much risk of having MODY diabetes. Usually thin, and you'll have a younger mother, brother having diabetes presented at 30, and fairly thinnish people. And if you have that risk, they should be tested. Now, we can't diagnose based on history taking, we have to do genetic testing. So there are several MODY from 30 to 14 and several being invented. And thanks to Prof. Mohan, we have found another MODY genes, which talks about a different type of diabetes. They are not classical type 2 diabetes, which is obesity related. They are mainly because if you've not been exercising, it tends to happen because of the genetic effect. And there are different markers, and it is not, we know little but about it, world needs to know more about it. Now, when it comes to MODY diabetes, as far as today is concerned, our one of the pioneer study that what we did is called MODY2. It's called GCK mutation in type 2 diabetes. So there are, when these women get pregnant, and if you know about their MODY status or genetic status, their treatment could be different from those who don't know the genetic status. The MODY or GCK mutations in pregnancy, if they develop diabetes during pregnancy, their treatment could be very different from those who don't have this genetic mutation. So that's called the precision medicine. So this is commonly used, and this is the first case we reported in diabetes care a few years ago. It's my colleagues, it was Sabreen, Swati, Ahmed, and the rest of my team, that what we found, that type 2 diabetes, which is different from type 2 diabetes, is single gene different diabetes. And if you identify the single gene defect, they may sometimes not require insulin treatment, that which is typically used in more than 50% patients who have diabetes. But the question is that these genetic testing takes few weeks time to understand. The pregnancy just 40 weeks time. So we need to know about the population before. And certain population in my clinical experience have studied genes, and we have treated them differently. And we have a last series of population where we have identified those genes and treated slightly differently from them. And that's what the modern medicine move, that everybody with the same small screen, same blanket screen, start treating without the genetic test. Now, these genetic testing may cost up to 15,000 to 20,000 in the commercial market. In a research lab, may cost 5,000 to 6,000. Just to identify one or two genes, forget about the rest of the whole 16 to 18 genes or other gene markers. So these are difficult, but this is used, and we have used, as personally as Dr. Chak, used in using these genes markers, genetic studying to treat type 2 diabetes, which could be different. If the same woman would have been treated by insulin, which would have not had any information, the baby would have affected size. Baby could have much smaller, and some more adverse effect would have happened. Now, when somebody comes in, we always don't know. Usually the gestational diabetes or pregnancy-induced diabetes tends to happen in 24 to 28 weeks time. We can't do genetic testing. It's not easily available. It's expensive way. We cannot suspect in everyone until unless we have more genetic studies, wider population study. And we have tried to do the population prevalence study. We are also studying about different gene study, part of the DBT funded studies, along with the Prof. Nihal Thomas group from Vellore, that we are trying to understand a different type of single gene defect diabetes, which can tell us about the diabetes differently. Because certain MODY we need to treat not with metformin, which is the first line of treatment, we need to treat what we call sulfonylurea. So it's very important to understand. So what we need for a common people to understand, that if you are very young, in 20s and 30s, very thin, if you have subsequent family members have diabetes much earlier, and they may not, all of them don't develop classical diabetes complications, they need to be studied. Especially if you have any planning for pregnancy, if you're thin, if you have family history of diabetes, you should ask your doctor about understanding what special MODY2, we call it GCK mutation study, and that will be helpful. And that's what you call it, a personalized medicine. Personalized medicine is also used, you know, when a young baby is born, you must have heard about type 1 diabetes. Earlier, we used to bracket any young born baby as type 1 diabetes. But what we have found in Prof. Hartsley's study, then 15 years ago from Exeter, we found that a lot of young, more than 20 years ago, I think, that more than so-called defined type 1, they have been on insulin all their life. And we found that those have newborn diabetes. They have different diabetes. They have different MODY mutations. And their mutations are different, and they have been taken off insulin and given sulfonylurea. Mind it, they have diabetes right from the birth of first 6 months. I'm not talking of all type 1, I'm just talking about certain small population who have diabetes, right? We call it neonatal diabetes, right from the young population, less than 6 months old, in some people less than 3 years old. But most people after 3 years old have type 1 diabetes. They have been studied, but they have not been found at single gene defect. But mainly I'm talking about young, very young, it's almost like a birth to 6 months and rarely up to 3 years time. Their insulin been stopped and been switched to small sulfonylurea dose, small tablets, and they are doing well on that. A large number of conversions have happened from those who have been so-called treated with type 1. When you call type 1, they require insulin all their life, but they have been taken off, and they have been diagnosis changed because we had new genetic information. And there have been few studies, again coming from South, from Mohan group, they have done a large number of study on neonatal diabetes, that has helped. So if you look into genetic studies and marker of genetic markers in population of diabetes, neonatal diabetes, Modi G6 imitations and pregnancy has helped individuals who can tell you the Modi 1 and 3 also would have a different set of treatment. And these Modi 1 and 2 and 3 are common Modi diabetes that can help us in day-to-day clinical medicine. But neonatal gestational has got huge changes. The Modi 1 and 2 also would help us. So if you have a family history which is thin, younger, we call it autosomal dominant, and they have done, their diabetes should be treated in a different manner. But we need genetic studies. We need to have understanding among clinicians about genetic studies. We more need more labs, more research, more scientific data, more robust data, more passion to understand the reason for type 2 diabetes. Then we'll know more about it.